Welcome to Tales from SYL Ranch, the BitChute channel where everyone is entitled to my opinion, and I'm Bill Stone. While I have your attention, I'd like to ask that if you like what I'm doing, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, share me on social media, and tell all of your friends, family, neighbors, pets, and livestock to do the same. I would appreciate your support via my PayPal tip jar, my subscribe star, my merch stores on Teespring, or a place on my website where you can support me further. And there are links to all of these in my description box. Yesterday, I made a video, if you're not commercially viable, move to BitChute, and there is a link to that video in my description box. In it, I talked about the issue that is currently on the minds of any YouTuber not presently making money for YouTube, the terms of service changes due to a start applying in December 10th, 2019. The pertinent part of those changes reads, YouTube may terminate its legal agreement with you if the provision of the service to you by YouTube is, in YouTube's opinion, no longer commercially viable. Now, in the last 24 hours, after experiencing a lot of pushback from users and a lot of bad press, YouTube has clarified the terms of service through several tweets. Hey, geniuses, if your legal document needs clarifying, maybe it's a crappy legal document. I mean, the entire concept of a legal document is to make the terms clear, right? So yesterday, an unnamed YouTube weasel told Mashable, quote, "We made some changes to our terms of service in order to make them easier to read and to ensure that they're up to date. We're not changing the way our products work, or how we collect or process data, or any of your settings," end quote. Note that this particular weasel didn't say that YouTube wouldn't terminate your channel for not being commercially viable. They just said that they won't be changing the products, the collection of data that allows them to create a detailed profile of you for advertising purposes, or your settings, whatever the hell that applies to. Nowhere did they say they won't terminate your account. And then later yesterday, another YouTube weasel sent Mashable the following missive via a public tweet from Team YouTube's account. Quote, "To clarify, there are no new rights in our terms of service to terminate an account because it's not making money. As before, we may discontinue certain YouTube features or parts of the service for either if they're outdated or have low use. This does not impact our creators slash viewers in any new ways." Keep that word new in mind. Because note that this little weasel didn't say anything about not terminating accounts for being commercially viable. They said there are no new rights in the terms of service. And they are absolutely correct. YouTube has always had the right to terminate anyone's account for any reason whatsoever, nor do they have to tell you why they did it. And I know because they terminated my first account with YouTube. There were over 300 videos deleted overnight when I got 3 community guidelines strikes in the space of 24 hours. No reason was given for these strikes, and they never were. YouTube doesn't have to give a reason. They have always had the right to terminate your account for any reason. They have just explicitly enumerated a reason, that's all. And this particular weasel also said that they can discontinue parts of the service, for example, if they're outdated or have low usage. Well, they've always had this right. I mean, just see the failed integration of YouTube and Google Plus as an example. YouTube constantly adds and removes services. This is no change whatsoever, just as he says. And note also that this particular weasel isn't named. It came from Team YouTube's account. It in no way is official nor legal, and YouTube has no obligation to adhere to anything any of its army of Team YouTube employees may happen to post. The Team YouTube account is really a way for large creators to bring attention to an issue that they might have that YouTube is taking excessively long to address. As for we peons, well, the Team YouTube account is and has always been a complete waste of time. In short, nothing has been changed since yesterday. Nothing has been clarified. An unnamed spokesperson said that YouTube isn't changing its products, at least at the moment, and won't stop gathering data on you, and that it won't alter your settings, whatever the hell that means. Another weasel from an account that YouTube is under no obligation to oblige to, said that they have the right to do things that they have always had the right to do. Not a single one of these sources has said that the new terms of service doesn't mean exactly what it says. Quote, YouTube may terminate its legal agreement with you if the provision of the service to you by YouTube is, in YouTube's opinion, no longer commercially viable. Nothing has changed, except that YouTube is facing negative press, and so has decided to backpedal slightly with a little legalese. But don't believe anything that YouTube weasels ever say. From Susan Wojcicki on down, they already say that they don't derank videos based on political content, but we know for a fact that they do. And I have anecdotal evidence. My libertarian commentary videos rarely break double digits on YouTube. And yet, the single time that I had something positive to say about a Democrat, that video currently stands at 312 views, 36 likes, no dislikes, and tons of engagement. If that video was one of the few that wasn't deranked, I will eat my hat. Now, YouTube also says that it doesn't discriminate by political content when showing your videos in sidebars of suggested views, and we know for a fact that this is a lie. YouTube has already said that they show your videos to your subscribers when you post, and this is utter nonsense. I presently have 139 subscribers, yet all of my videos, they rarely break 50 views. If all of my subscribers were seeing my videos when I post them, then I would naturally see more views. And this is actually borne out by my views on BitChute, which I presently have 120 subscribers, and my videos typically see in excess of 200 views. I have several that in the thousands of views. In fact, the view count isn't even comparable. They are all higher on BitChute. That couldn't happen unless YouTube was masking my videos from both subscribers and users generally. YouTube is demonstrably deceptive. There is no reason to believe that they're not being deceptive now. They just haven't altered what powers they have, just reiterated what YouTube has already had. That's what their weasels said. Now, as a libertarian, I believe that YouTube has the right to arbitrarily delete any channel it likes, including mine. It's a private service with its own infrastructure. I no more have the right to force them to host my content free of charge than I have to force a baker to make a cake free of charge. However, as a libertarian, I also believe that you have the right to vote with your feet and to move to a free speech alternative. If YouTube doesn't want me, I will not let the door hit my ass on the way out. Yesterday's video therefore stands. Leave YouTube voluntarily. Open an account on BitChute, as it truly is a free speech alternative. If you're a small creator, you'll probably see your view and sub count go up rapidly. As with me, it will outpace YouTube in very short order, and you'll find that your views will start to rival larger YouTube creators who are mirroring their content on BitChute. That has happened with a number of my videos. And if you're a viewer, you're going to see a service with wildly differing content than YouTube already has with their bland offering. If you're on the political right or libertarian, you're going to find many whose content you prefer over what YouTube offers. And the same can be said if you're on the left or if you have interests outside of politics. YouTube sucks. BitChute for the win. And that is all that I have to say about that. I would love to keep the conversation going, so please leave your comments, questions, and nasty remarks, and I'll do my best to respond to them. So thanks for watching. That's all the time that we have today for this episode of the highly acclaimed, world-renowned Tales from SYL Ranch, the BitChute channel, where everyone is entitled to my opinion. And I'm Bill Stone.
Ultimate power in this world has always been one simple thing: the control and manipulation of minds.